Hi YouTube, welcome to another review of mine. This time it's of the Hot Toys 1/6 scale The Avengers Loki. And as per usual, before we look at the figure, we look at the packaging first, which is right here. So we'll just take off Loki from the review area and bring out the packaging. As you can see there in front of the box, this is a nice image of Loki from the movie. Down there it says Marvel The Avengers with a nice gold shine in there, reflective part I mean, and this like embossed A right here, the Avengers logo. Down there says movie masterpiece, Hot Toys. And on the side, the picture continues from the front, and down there we got a symbol for Loki, again made with that same reflective gold looking foil on the front. At the back we got their warnings and plain dark green over here, and here on the other side we've got another continuation of the photo from the front, and again the Loki symbol on this, we made with the same gold foil. At the top of the box it says Loki in nice white font on a gold or bronze background. So really nice packaging on here. And when you slip this sleeve out, so once you remove the sleeve you get you'll see this window right here. This is the place where the figure will be displayed or placed when he's in package or when you first get him in package. It's colored bronze again with some white typograph there of the Loki symbol and the Avengers logo. Same with the other side, and again some cast and crew credits for this Loki figure. Again, Hot Toys down there. So enough of the box, so here we've got Loki. Really, really nice. Let me just straighten him out for you guys. Let me remove the spear here. Straighten out his arms. His head. So yeah, really nice figure here, and another masterpiece by Hot Toys. Hot Toys never fails, especially with this head sculpt. Tell me if that doesn't look like Tom Hiddleston, the actor from the movie. This is just wow. Another top-notch job here by Hot Toys. Look at those eyes, those creepy-looking eyes. They look really real, especially with that clear, shiny paint applied onto that. It just adds another level of realism. And again, just the detail on this thing, the skin, and the painting on the eyebrows, the lips, the sculpting. It's just immaculate. And the tailoring on the figure is not to be overlooked. It looks really nice. It looks just like his outfit in the movie. This is of course fake leather, but it still looks really good. And these metal looking bits are here are actually hard plastic. Also this one here, and these shoulder pieces right here, and the forearm gauntlets. As you can see here, really, really nice. As you can see there, it has some shiny cloth there or material to simulate his costume in the movie, which is really nice. It gives off this really royal feel to the figure. Like he's a real royalty in Asgard. Of course he's exiled, but you know, he's still royalty. And just the amount of sculpting on these parts too, just wow. The painting on there looks really metal, although it's just plastic. Also this part here, these gaps, this is where you'll put the cape, which I'll show you later on. Again, with the detail on here, just really nice. It continues onto the back, again with the fake leather, just really nice. All this detail right here, which you'll never even notice in the movie, is perfectly captured on this figure right here, especially this part here, the thing that's almost similar to Thor's costume, and also the side of his thighs, boots. This part is separate from the actual foot, so that it articulates freely. Just the detail on this thing, just wow. Love those gold buckles. And it even has dirt on his shoes. Just really nice. Again, like I said, another top-notch execution here by Hot Toys. And like I said, he has a cape. Right here. Just put him down there for a second. He has a cape right here. It is made of a nice green material, nice green cloth, and it is ironed really well. As you can see there, and I'm gonna put it on the figure. And putting on the cape, it adds another level of royalty or regality to this figure. It's just really nice the way it's ironed on here. As you can see, all those creases are really awesome. Again, it is made of a nice green cloth. And right here, I forgot to mention his hair sculpt right here. I love this. And of course, Loki won't be complete without his helmet. He, of course, comes with one, and it is here. As you can see here, it is, again, made of that nice, sturdy plastic. Although, you got to be careful with this. I'll show you that part later. But again, it is made of this nice plastic. Although, it looks like metal, it is plastic. It is the paint. It is the effect of the paint. That makes it look like metal. Just really nice right there, the detailing on this thing. As you can see there, if you can see there, right? All those lines, just all those intricacies on this helmet. And yes, he has the horns. Loki won't be complete without the horns. And yes, it comes in two pieces. As you can see here, it has those tabs. It tabs onto these parts over here. When you close it down, first you gotta do is take Loki. You slowly put this thing on. You just slowly and gently pry it open like that. And gently put it onto the head sculpt of Loki. Like so. And get this part right here, the upper part. And close it down on his head and make sure to clasp all those tabs together. Once you put the helmet on, it looks like this, which is really, really awesome. Captures how he looks in the movie. Again, it adds another level of regality to this figure. Just really, really nice. You can see there, looks perfectly good on his head. Not too big, not too small, just the right size. So now here we've got Loki in his full Asgardian regalia or costume. Just really, really nice. I can't say enough good things about this figure. It's just awesome. Again, another masterpiece by Hot Toys, as I keep saying over and over again since the start of this review. So for articulation, his head is on a ball joint. So it rotates side to side, goes side to side. I mean like pivot side to side. Goes up and down, which is really nice. Arms can go in and out, forward and back. Not all the way around, since it's quite restricted by the costume. Elbows bend. I don't know if it's at 1 point or 2 points, but it's most likely at 2 points because it is a true tight body underneath. Arms can rotate and go in and out. There's also this armpit piece right here, which can go forward and back. Rotate at the top part of the bicep. His torso can, he has a torso joint right there that goes forward and back, as well as side to side. I guess he has a waist swivel in there, but can't quite move because of, again, restriction because of the costume. Legs can go forward and back, in and out, rotate at the top part of the thigh, bend at 2 points at the knee, go up and down at the feet, side to side, which is really nice. Just everything, every articulation you could think of that has Hot Toys has done, especially with their true type bodies, this figure has. It's just somewhere restricted due to the costume, but oh well, it looks nice at least. So for accessories, I already showed you his cape and helmet. Again, Loki won't be complete without his spear, or I don't know what it's actually called in the movie. So Tony jokingly calls it the Spear of Destiny. He comes with that accessory. In this version, the shorter one, as you can see here, the nice detailing again, all those lines, the shading, the shininess, the metallic looking. This isn't metal, this is plastic. It's just the paint that gives off the effect. It's got that blue gem right there. It is made of a clear plastic, And it has some detailing right there, as you can see, like little cracks. Just the level of detail on this thing is just top notch. And if he comes with the shorter version, he also comes with the longer version of the spear, which is right here. You can see the differences in the blade. This is the long one, this is the short one. You can see this one looks more menacing, but still the level of detail right here is just the same as the shorter one. All those lines, the paint, the metallic finish. Just comes with a total of 9 hands. Two of these gripping hands right here. I've got one on the figure right there. As you can see here, the level of detail on this thing is just nice. Again, the skin tone is really perfect. As you can see there, again, sculpting on this part of his hand right here. The painting too. Really awesome. He comes two of these, as I said. Two of these relaxed palm hands. Two of these holding hands. These are used to hold his daggers, which I'll show later. Again, nice detailing right there. Two of these open hands, like casting hands, I think, or like just gesture hands, gestural hands. Actually comes with 3 of these. I've got one on the figure right there. And like as I mentioned before, he comes with daggers. He doesn't come with one, but 2 daggers. Again, nice detailing on these things. The camera can focus properly right there. The lines, the metallic finish. Again, this is made of plastic, also quite sharp, but still the level of detail, it's just nice. So if you get one of those hands, like this one right here, you can easily put it in, like so. Just needs a little finessing, like so. Doesn't quite hold it properly, or as well as I'd like it to be. Maybe if I wedge it a little more down there, the bottom part. Okay, right there. It isn't as loose anymore. It's just nice. It can also hold it like this. If you want to, he can do that. And he can also do that with 2 of the daggers. Oops. As if he's holding to throw. He also comes with these handcuffs. This is real metal chain right here, by the way. As you can see there. This handcuffs was shown in the movie in the last scenes of the movie where Loki is taken back in Asgard by Thor. In order to put this on, you just pop off Loki's hands and slip this in and then pop the hands back. Again, really nice detailing on these things. And lastly, he comes with his muzzle, again shown in the final part of the movie. I don't know if it's metal, I do think it is plastic though, but again with that nice metallic finish and that bronze coloring and the black lines, just nice. And a Hot Toys figure won't be complete without the base, like this one. It is the standard Hot Toys base. It says they're Marvel's Avengers, Loki, and it has the adjustable cradle right here. So for scale here, we've got Loki next to the DX-12 Batman, also from Hot Toys. The Playard Sky General Zod and the 6-inch Marvel Legends. Return of the Marvel Legends. He is quite taller than Batman here, even without his helmet, as you can see, as you can see in their eye level. And he is also taller, obviously, than a normal 9-inch scale figure, such as the Player Sky General Zod, and a 6-inch figure, such as the Doctor Doom figure down there. So do I recommend this figure? Absolutely. This thing is another masterpiece, as I kept on saying throughout this review by Hot Toys, yet again. Just everything from sculpt, what more would you expect from Hot Toys on this department? Sculpt, paint, detail, articulation, everything about this figure is great. Even the number of accessories is quite acceptable. It's not as many as the other releases by Hot Toys, but still it is acceptable. So yeah, if you're a big fan of Loki, of the Hiddleston, or the Avengers by Marvel, the movie, then this figure is a really must get for you. Again, given it is not for everyone, it is an expensive figure, but if you have the means to get it, absolutely get it, because he is a very, very good figure. So yeah, thanks again for watching my review from ESanchezVids. This is me. saying goodbye.